I'm Ted Koppel.
I'm Tex Vataxel, the number devil.
I'm Robert.
And I'm the cameraman.
I don't think I'm on the right set.
I'm Tex Vataxel, the number devil.
I'm Robert.
I'm Ted Koppel. And I'm Ted Koppel. These stories and more today on 5 Minutes. Imagine a world where small devils creep into struggling math students' dreams to help them with their studies. A world where the goal of everybody is to get into math paradise. A place where the world's foremost mathematicians go after their worldly life. This world is very real to our guest today, Quetzalcoatl. The Number Devil. Number Devil, I'm proud to have you here today.
Good to be on here, Ted.
So, tell me, Number Devil, what does it mean to be a Number Devil?
Oh, I creep into little kids' dreams and I teach them math, you know, the beautiful little children teach them math.
Interesting. So, what was your favorite dream with Robert?
Oh, joy! Oh, my favorite night. Besides the last night, I think. Oh, my favorite night. My favorite night was the ninth night. The day of my time, Robert's sequences.
Alright, Boyle, what are these numbers?
Those are the prima donna numbers.
Exactly, kid. So this is called a sequence. A sequence is a progression of numbers based off of the previous number or a formula. So these numbers right here, they're called the term numbers. They're just the count numbers, and for every progression number, there's a term number that matches straight up with it. Just like that, boyo.
But you said there were two ways to get a term sequence number. Explain that!
Zimmerdida, kid! You're asking the good questions now. If you stay on this path, we can go straight to number hell! I mean, number heaven, of course. No, you get what I mean. Alright, but going straight to the math. So here, we have an arithmetic sequence. So in this formula, it's a recursive formula, meaning it's based off of the previous term. So you start off with the first number, and you just keep adding on and on and on. This little doohickey right here, it means the previous term. So you just keep adding on to the one right before it. You know, because of that, if you try and find a big number, you can imagine it'd be a real pain in the patootie to try and find one of those. So moving on, here's an explicit formula. So here, you start off with the first term, and then you plug in whatever term number you want in there, and you get whatever you want. Just like that, boy. Oh.
Ted Koppel, likey. So, Tex-Mex. Was there any perhaps embarrassing material that wasn't put into the book?
Very much so, Ted. Oh, I remember the first night I met that little boy.
I am the number! Yourself?
No.
Come on now. You're like 12. You shouldn't be doing this. I don't think math is your problem right now. Whatever. Let's go do some math.
Hilarity at its finest. So Number Devil, I'm assuming you've helped other children?
Indeed.
Who was your favorite kid?
Oh, I remember it vividly.
And you take the inverse of the alpha coefficient and divide it by the derivative of Planck's constant, and you get beta. And that is why 1 + 1 = 2. Did you get that, Terrence?
Yeah, I got it like 3 minutes before you did. This stuff's elementary, Number Devil.
Oh, you're such a good little boy. Now, why don't you just go run off and watch your Sesame Street?
Yay!
You're gonna be
be your great mathematician someday, Terence Tao.
Yeah! That kid who said Pry was wrong and Tao was right. So I understand you've brought some unseen footage from the underground movie version of your book. Can we see it?
Why else would I bring it? Let's enjoy this beautiful little scene I brought here.
Hey, Number Devil, remember those rutabaga numbers? What if we take the rutabaga of a negative number?
I'm taking the rutabaga of a negative number. Time and space rip at the seams! No number multiplied by itself gets a negative number. It's like divided by zero. Ah, Robert, that's called an imaginary number.
Well, there's something imaginary.
Better, Robert?
Not really.
Well, what do you want me to do?
Well, what if we take one of those crazy imaginary numbers and mix it with a wacko normal number and maybe the craziness will balance out?
Oh, well, call me Shirley.
Okay, Shirley.
Those are called complex numbers. It's when you add a real number to an imaginary number. And let me give you the basics here, boy. So, when you have complex numbers and you want to add or subtract them, you need to match up the imaginary numbers with the real numbers. And then add or subtract as needed, and you got yourself a solution.
Okay, well, what about multiplying and dividing?
Well, you can figure that out on your own in Number Paradise. By the way, did I tell you the number gods have sent out our invitation for the beginning of our immortalization process?
They did? Let's go!
Hop on my back, kid! Let's fly!
I can show you the world. Shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes.
I wasn't very good at flying, though.
A whole new world. A new
Ted Kaplan approved! So, do you think we could try that flying thing, maybe? Yes, kind of.
I don't see why not. Hop on and let's go! Alright, let's hit it, kid! Yeah!
I can be your hero, baby. I can kiss away the pain. I will stand by you forever.
Ted Koppel approved! Ted Koppel can fly! This is Ted Koppel signing off for 5 minutes. Stick with us next week when we interview the Talking Brownie!
Would you run and hide? Am I in too deep? Have I lost my mind? I don't care.